हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग एंड वेलकम बैक आफ्टर दसरा वेकेशन। वेल स्टूडेंट्स, आई थिंक द प्रीवियस लेसन्स व्हाट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड, दोज लेसन्स आर यू आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज एंड यू आर गोइंग टू प्रिपेयर फॉर योर नेक्स्ट अपकमिंग टर्म एग्जामिनेशन। वेल स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई विल मूव टूवर्ड्स दिस सर्चिंग फॉर फूड, द नेक्स्ट लेसन, द सर्चिंग फॉर food. Before starting this lesson, I would like to give an introduction, students. So we know what is the meaning of food and what is the meaning of searching, all those things. So previous class we have discussed in previous chapters. Well students, if we feel angry, so we are the human beings, if we feel hungry, we will search for food, right? We will search for food, something or any eatables or snacks or breakfast or meals or vegetables. So like this we have varieties of food. We will go for our favorite, yes or no? So we will go to the hotels or we will go to a kitchen and we will search. So usually in animals and birds, so it is not going to happen, yes or no? So they won't get any ready food like us. So how they are going to fulfill their stomach, yes or no? And why they are, these animals and birds, feeling to have food? Of course, to fulfill their stomach, yes or no? So before that, the concept of a sense of organs. So in our very first line, so there is in chapter 8, page number 36, chapter 8, in very first line, so they indicated in your textbook a sense of organs. As you know that the sense of organs, nose, eyes, ears, our tongue, so these are all examples for sense of organs, yes or no? And these are connected to our brain. If we feel hungry, if we feel very angry, so our the sense of organs, we get some smell of food, the nose is going to help us, and to taste, the tongue, it's going to help us, and these are all which is connected to our brain, yes. So same like us, even in birds and animals also have some organs, some sense of organs. So with the help of these sense of organs, animals and birds and insects, almost all living organisms, are going to have food, or it is going to search their prey or food. Prey means it's a food. In food chain we have discussed what is the meaning of prey. So in this lesson we are going to discuss about the sense of organs of animals and insects, all those things. Just hold on, we will go to the lesson. Well students, the sense of organs in animals, so usually some animals and birds and insects, they have very powerful vision to see and very poor vision, and smell, they can smell from a certain distance, and sound, for example bat is a mammal, it can't able to see, its vision is too poor, so it reflects, it use ecosystems, echo, the sound will reflect. So this kind of, these are all sense of organs in animals and birds, means living organisms apart from human beings. So in this lesson students, we are going to discuss about ants, how ants are going to search its food, and snakes, dogs, owl, these are all very familiar, you may have observed in National Geographic and Discovery channels. So once again, little bit of information we are going to study in our textbook. And the vultures, bears, shark, insects, whale and dolphin, so these are the mammals and animals and the birds how it is going to search its prey. So regarding this, we are going to discuss one by one. So first I will start with the ant. Well students, just open your textbook, page number 38, sorry, page number 36. Okay, I will read for you students here. So ants, so just leave a piece of bread on the floor, it attracts a lot of ants. Ants do not have well developed eye to see food, but they have a strong sense of smell. So what is the meaning of this? So ants have very strong sense of smell. You may observe the ants. Ants can be seen everywhere in planet Earth. So it is in our society, it is in our forest areas. So wherever we see, so we will find ants. So especially the ants have very small eyes, very very small eyes. Sometimes they can't able to find out its food, but also with the help of smell the ants will get its own food. And you know, you may observe the ant will communicate. Ants will use antennas, which is provided by the gifted by the nature. So it won't make any sound like other animals and birds. So it, but also the ants will communicate with the help of antenna. And ant have a special feature in its. So what is the meaning of that? Only few ants will go for in search of food. So when the ants will go to search of food, it will release a chemical trail. Chemical means it is a kind of a liquid content which is going to release by ants when it is going for search its food. So other remaining ants will follow the other ant which is going to search for a food. So these are the feature which is gifted by the nature or God for the ant. So this is the example for ants. So ant has the sense of organ. So it is very powerful smell sensing organ in its. So this is about ants. And next is snake. Just hold on students. Well students, the next one is snake. So I will read for you once again. Just snakes have good eyesight over short distance, but their sense of smell is more accurate. So they use it search for food. So what is the meaning of this? Well students, just now I told you the snakes, you know the attitude of the snakes. So it always flicks its tongue outside. Alva nalgena yavaglano tana bayinda aache aagta irutte yavdu how. So means the snake flicks its tongue outside to observe. So what is there in its surrounding. So with the help of this tongue, the snakes can easily identify its own prey or food or objects, what is there in its surroundings, whether it is food, whether it is water, whether it is any other animal, all those things. So it flicks its tongue and it touches roof of its mouth. Andre haavu nalgena aache aake horagade enide anta nalge inda adra baaye ondu top ge en madu top of the mouth andre baaye mel bhagakke aa nalgena touch madate. So avaga en agutte aavina sutta mutta enide anta adike gotagutte. So what sodana navu enanta karithivi, flicks its tongue, touches its roof of its mouth. So this is the feature, special feature of snake. Well students, the next one is the dog. So one of the most familiar for human beings, so it is our pet, supposed to say. So many of you know about the dog, so I think you don't need much explanation about the dog. So it has very good sense of organ, like it is very good in smelling and the sound by hearing. So with the help of its these two sense of organ, the dog is using these two sense of organs to get its food usually. And some kind of dogs being used in police department to detect if it is any against to what law and order, if anyone suspected any criminal activities or theft or any murder. In such cases, the dogs are being used in police department. Especially we used to call sniffer dogs andre smell na adarisi and vasane adarisi enadru criminal activities na nadidre, so adanna help madodakke police navarge investigation ge use agute. So once again, the dogs have very good sense of smell and hearing. Just hold on, students, so we'll move towards further. Well, students, next one is vultures and bear. So they have amazing sense of smell. Vulture and bear both having very good sense of smell. So vultures from the sky, when it's flying, so it can observe its prey for a very long distance. So a good sense of smell, they smell even dead animals. The vultures can smell dead animals. So for vultures, we used to call scavengers. Scavengers means very neatly it is going to have its food. It is going to finish each and every thing, so of the dead animals. So that's why we used to call scavengers. And if we come to bears, we have many kind of bears, polar bear and the forest, green forest, evergreen forest bears, okay, Asian bear. So there are many kind of bears. So almost all the bears have very good sense of smell. For example, polar bear can smell 20 kilometers away. Polar bear can smell its prey 20 kilometers away. So especially the polar bear likes seal, which is present in seas and oceans. So it is also, seal is also aquatic animal. So this is about the vulture and bear. So one of the important feature is both are very good in sense of smell. Well, students, we'll move further. The next one is the shark. So shark have excellent sense of smell. So along with the sharks, the rats, cockroaches and bees, so these species also have very good excellent sense of smell. So with the help of this sense of smell, so these animals, means living organisms, catch hold its prey. So if you come to sharks, so sharks have very good excellent sense of smell. So it can smell a tiny drop of blood. So usually you know where is this shark is living. So sharks are living in seas and oceans. So seas and oceans are very enormous, very big, yes or no? So in seas and oceans, the sharks can easily identify or smell a single drop of blood. So that much powerful sense of smells are having these living organisms. So if you come to hawk, so it has very good vision, andre drushti. So far I was talking about the smell, so now I am speaking about the vision. So hawks, the eagle, the kite and vultures, they have very good sense of vision, very good sense of vision. So they can easily identify its prey from flying high, means very far distance from the sky. This type of birds can easily identify its prey. So we'll move further. Just hold on.